Hello everybody, I bring greetings from King George's Medical University, Lucknow, India. I work as endocrine and breast surgeon, and I'm going to talk on a very important issue, that is, can we prevent development of breast cancer? Is breast cancer preventable? How? So there are certain risk factors which can influence the development of breast cancer. Risk factor may not directly cause cancer, but it influences the development of mutations which lead to growth in the cancer cells. So why are we talking about prevention? Because you see, in India, 70% of the patients which we see with breast cancers, they come in very advanced stage. In West, unlike most, are very screen detected tiny cancers, and they have more than 90% survival rate, compared to India, where 50% of the patients, they die. One out of two women treating with breast cancer, she dies, because survival depends on the stage. And why to wait for breast cancer to develop? We should talk about prevention before, not don't let it happen. That's what is this. See, education matters. This is a statement by a survivor who says, being a survivor now, I realized I was not educated or aware about what breast cancer actually was and how it impacted and affected lives. In COVID pandemic era, breast cancer or any cancer did not wait. Doctors and patients struggled a lot in managing patients with cancers. And breast cancer is not a disease of only women. It also affects men. This is a huge crowd of people. This is just one of the sectors of the pictures demonstrating and depicting that cancer waits for none. If you see, in 1990s, all the orange areas in India were very few, which shows the incidence rate of cancers. And in 2016, if you see, majority of the India has become orange or red, which shows that the incidence is rising every year. Now they say 1 in 8 women is having the risk of developing breast cancer. What are we waiting for? 1 in 1 women? If you see earlier, all the blues 25 years back, breast cancer was a disease of old age, happening after 50 to 60 years. But now, if you see the red blocks, it is coming to the younger women in 30s and even in 20s. What is happening? Young people are dying of cancer. This is a common scenario which we see, fungating large breast cancers, and even the cancer is so advanced that it affects the hand, lymphatics, and hands get swollen. Why do people suffer? Why do people wait for so long? We are talking that not even a single cancer cell to develop. That is what prevention is. So we have a long journey to travel and to come back to the stage of prevention. What are the reasons of delay? From patient's point, they ignore it as it is painless lump mostly. They go for alternate medicines with the fear of finances. They are hesitant. Cancer is like a social stigma. They don't want to talk about it. There may be a huge distance between their home and the hospital. That may involve the travel costs and the logistics. And then for women, unfortunately, who bears the treatment cost? The maternal side or the husband side? That is a very sad story. However, in government sectors, the cancer treatment is free. But even this information is not being available to people in the peripheries. They are scared to come to hospitals, but when they come to know that treatment is free. Then the provider delay are also there because the diagnostic facilities are not available everywhere. In the peripheries, they may not have labs or infrastructure to diagnose cancer. So their patients are referred late. There's lack of coordination between the doctors and they don't know where to refer. We don't have proper awareness programs to educate people about cancers and how to prevent it, and their lack of support groups which can support people mentally, physically, spiritually, every form to help them walk on the journey of cancer, unfortunately, if they have to. So the problems are there are no organized screening programs, late stage of presentation, increased cost of treatment, increased complications related to treatment, and above all, the survival rate is very low. So the solution is that we need to pay more attention to health promotion, which is ahead of clinical treatment. Why to wait for treatment? Why can't we prevent it? Prevention doesn't cost much money. I'm going to talk about risk factors which can be modified. We just have to relook on our lifestyle. Modern life is full of stress. People are running around everywhere. They have sleep deprivation. Because of high level of stress, what happens? Cortisol's hormones go higher in body, which reduces immunity and promotes mutation so that the cancer cells, they develop and they grow. Because we are always in the hurry, we don't exercise, we don't give enough time for our lifestyle, for mental, physical, spiritual health, we gradually start becoming obese because the food we take is mostly the fast food, which is rich in carbohydrates. It may be frozen food. It may be junk food. We don't really give emphasis on what we eat. We give more emphasis on what we taste and what taste suits us. Alcohol and smoking are also the risk factors for causing cancer. Pregnancy and breastfeeding, however, is protective. But now, because of the modern lifestyle, women are opting to delay pregnancy and breastfeeding also is getting reduced. But we have to know breastfeeding is protective. There are a lot of harmful chemicals everywhere. The pesticides, the antibiotics we inject in the crops, the hormones we inject in the crops, so that crops, vegetables, fruits look bigger, they look nicer, but they're causing cancer. So we ourselves are inducing cancer. The chemicals in the plastic is everywhere. If you cook food in the plastic ware in microwave, the heat which is produced because of the heating, it interacts with the plastics and the chemicals are released which cause cancer. The cosmetics which we use, which we wear, the perfumes, the lotions, the hair chemicals, the straighteners which we use, the shampoos we use, there's so many things, cosmetics we use, they have adulterations. The air we breathe, the pollutant in the air are also promoting cancer. The water we drink is so contaminated. So somebody has said breast is a sponge for everything in the environment. The hormones, younger women, they take OCPs, oral contraceptive pills, which have got estrogen, and that is also one of the promoting factors for cancers. Then hormone replacement therapy in the postmenopausal women also has a slight risk. So how can we detect an early stage, even if there is a cancer? We should know about breast self-examination. We should be aware of our own body. What changes are happening in our body, we should be aware about it. And then, if needed, we can have clinical breast examination by a doctor every 6 months, which is useful in developing countries because it doesn't cost much involved. If possible, we can go for mammography after 40 years of age, once in 2 years. However, if mammography is not feasible, at least breast self-examination and clinical breast examination is the choice. Breast examination doesn't cost anything. It's just you have to know about how to do it. Women can do standing in the, or men can do standing in while taking shower, standing in front of the mirror, seeing the nipples are both at the same size. There is no change in the skin. The nipple is not retracted inside. There's no change in the size of the breast. Any lump formation, we have to examine in the clockwise direction. Also in the lying down position to see if any change, we should report to the doctor. So the take home message is we should think pink. Pink represents breast cancer awareness, and we should live green, have a healthy lifestyle. Breast cancer, yes, it is preventable. Provided we have a healthy lifestyle, we exercise regularly, exercise oxygenates the cells and reduces the cancer cells mutations. So we should have more informed lifestyle and healthcare choices. So knowing that breast cancer exists, the incidence is rising every year is not enough. We have to pass it on this information to others, create more awareness, and create more awareness, especially about the preventable risk factors, which can modify and stop, even prevent the development of cancer. Thank you.